Thanks very much. It's a pleasure and privilege to be here today. We're amongst the best of the best. And Reggie and I are feeling very, very fortunate to be amongst you as you guys are sitting here on the eve or in the weeks preceding your championship games. And I just want to tip our collective hat to everybody in the room for a job well done. Coaches, players, like, give yourselves a hand. It's a great, great job. You know, I do this for a living in terms of going around the country and try to find the best young people to come and be a part of our university. And I can tell you without any hesitation that the state of California, in particular the southern section, is there's no place better in terms of finding quality young people, not just because they have great athletic gifts, but quality young people who have everything you're looking for as a student, as an athlete, to represent all the great universities in this area. And I can just tell you that it's a privilege to go around to the different high schools and to shake hands with the great coaches and administrators who do such a great job in these schools, and talk to them about their young people who, on almost a yearly basis, are overachieving and doing things that are special beyond belief, both on and off the field. So again, we want you to know that we take great pride in being in this area and being part of this area and being part of the great sport of football, and just want you to know what a great job you guys are getting done. It really is fun to watch, and again, you're going to have a great weekend this weekend. With that being said, I want to share with you, in 1977, McClintock High School played Washington High School. I was the quarterback at McClintock, and the final score was 14-9. We won the state championship in Tempe, Arizona. It was the first state championship for McClintock High School. Washington was playing, I think, for their third. Their quarterback was a guy by the name of Mike Pagel, who ended up playing at Arizona State, went on to the Baltimore Colts, who then became the Indianapolis Colts. And late in the game, we were down 9-7. I hit a tight end by the name of Doug Garrett across the middle for about a 40-yard gain down to the 6-yard line, and then David Hines plowed it in from there. And the reason I bring all that up is not that you should know any of those names. I don't bring any of that for any reason other than to say that was 32 years ago, and I remember it like it was yesterday. And you guys are going to have that same kind of experience this weekend. You're going to be close to 49 years old, hopefully. You all get there to 49. And hopefully I get it there to 49. But God willing, we get to that time and we're going to have these cherished memories. And I remember it like it was yesterday. I remember all the guys on my football team. I remember getting on the bus at the conclusion of the game. We played at Sun Devil Stadium. It was a December night. It was cold. I remember getting on the bus and the Queen song, "We Are the Champions." We were singing it on the way back to our high school. And it was the first ever state championship for our high school. And I remember being part of that, and it was so special. And I thought that moment would last forever, and it has. And so I'm telling you that in advance of your weekend, because it's important that you take a time between now and then as you prepare and do the very best you can to play your best, that you take a moment to stop and smell the roses and realize that this is going to be a moment etched in time, regardless of whether you're victorious or not, that you're going to have to share with these guys who you've gone through a very, very special time in your life, that being your high school years. And I hope that you stay together and you stay friends for long, long thereafter. My 30th high school reunion was just 3 weeks ago. I was occupied. We had a game. But I'm told that it was a terrific night. I got on the phone with a bunch of guys that were there, and we talked again about this state championship game. So remember that it's a moment that you're going to have for the rest of your life, and prepare for it like it's going to be such, and make sure that you enjoy that moment. I promise your moms and dads will enjoy it. Hopefully the weather will be great, and you'll be out there, and may the best team win. But I also want to make sure that you guys do everything you can to enjoy the competition of the evening, and do it in the spirit of good sportsmanship. I mean, we're all champions in this room. You wouldn't be here if you weren't. And that at the end of the day, one team's going to have more points, but that doesn't mean that both teams didn't have an unbelievable year getting to that point. And then you ought to admire the other side, regardless of which side of that coin you're on. And look forward to that kind of evening, and then hopefully cherish those memories for a lifetime, because as I can tell you, they're fun to reflect on. They're big days. And I just want you to know that this is a great sport that we all get to play, because you can't do it by yourself. It requires a commitment by everybody involved, your coaches, the administrators. Everybody involved has to be pulling together to get you to this point. And you ought to celebrate that in advance of the game, and then celebrate it again after the game, because it really is a special, special time. We at UCLA are thrilled to be able to come to a bunch of the games. We're thrilled to have a number of kids from all your schools on our roster. And it's just a great tradition that you're carrying on here with the CIF Southern Section, because as I said, it's the best of the best. So congratulate yourselves. Enjoy this week of preparation and go get them this weekend. I'll be anxious to see how it turns out, and make sure you stop and smell the roses, because this will be a memory that someday you'll be standing in front of a bunch of folks and going through the last quarter of that drive, and it will be etched in your memory forever. Ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate you. Have a great, great weekend. Thank you.